As with all living things on the earth, trees, plants, birds, insects, animals, we need sunshine, water and air. We all emerge, develop and blossom. Our human time and rhythm can be very different to that of animals, of plants and of seasons. Yet we all share time, space and gravity. There are similarities between movement in nature and movement in dance. We can recognize qualities, energies, dynamics, rhythm and form in both. In this film, we have taken images from nature and worked with a dancer to translate them into her body. It is a short exploration of the similarities of the dances of nature and the dance qualities in the human body.
I was at the Art of Movement Studio in 55, 1955, with Lisa Edlava,
Okay,
and
yes.
did a year's course at that time. I really imbibed as much as possible, but the real learning was when the one and only hour I had with Lavan himself, where he made me aware of my unbalance of effort qualities. And that really made me work on myself and increase the vocabulary that I have in my movement expression.
That's it. So you've got a nice game of playing between heel next bit toe, heel next bit toe,
Yeah.
heel next bit toe, toe next bit heel,
Yeah.
toe next.
What do you think about using nature as a stimulus
Oh, I think
for
it's a lovely
helping
idea.
people to?
Using nature as a stimulus, I mean, that is where you get natural movement of life, plants, you name it, it's all around us.
Yes.
I used to make the students go to the zoo.
Now the hard shell and
Yes.
then the
Yes, the elastic
the
in
elastic. I had
Yes.
that stuff
Yes.
felt like.
That was
I
lovely.
can't just sit here and tell Lynette through the telephone what to
At that
do.
moment, I was coming up.
It is seeing her moving and it's seeing her doing that gives me the movement opportunity, the opportunity to observe her movement qualities in order to bring out those things that we want.
That's it. That's it. That's it. And then get still. And just perhaps you could have your knee moving, or your foot moving, or the lower bit moving. That's it. And the whole thing. And then lots of shooting into different directions. Cha, 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 cha. Leg as well. Cha, 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 cha. And rest. You're, Lynette, have a rest.
You're trying to draw out of her more whole body work,
Yes,
weren't you?
whole body work and in connection to what she was trying to express in the nature around us. So we had particular shapes, e.g. the
Egg.
egg. We had particular kind of movements, like the rhythmical bouncing of branches of trees. We had the movements of a caterpillar. And the fox and the deer, which I dearly wanted to do, we never got to.
No.
It helped enormously with Pam's video, whose observation and filming was quite extraordinarily good, for us to beam into, to be able to analyze what those qualities were, which I tried to help Lynette to express in her movement.
Yes, and we could see it develop. Yes, indeed.
So, I mean, a good choreographer is a good movement observer, but a good choreographer can enhance what is natural to the dancer before him or her. So you can adjust or make use of the natural rhythms of the person you're working with and adapt and add to their vocabulary if there is time.
One of my aims is to help dancers to draw out quality in their movement. That's what I need to work at.
Yes.
And
Now this is the most undefinable thing that he, in particular, of all dance gurus, have given us. Lavan has given us the qualitative aspect of how to express the qualitative aspects of movement expression.
Yes, and to seek out that and which we don't naturally have.
Yes, and to work at those areas which we were perhaps not born with, or because of the way our lives have lived, have not been expressed. That was a lovely day. It was great fun working with everybody to create that little bit of film.